called Bike Ride in the Orchards.
Let's go, Casey D. Reed! Woo!
Whoa. Whoa, fast pace, racing at the speed of 140. I can't stop myself. Can you do it for me? Drips of sweat and blisters on my Achilles tendon. I want to sit down, but I'm not reaching a dead end. I can feel the greatest moments passing me by when all I want to do is watch a sunset in the sky. Dance my heart out and listen to Elvis Presley. Touch a gorilla, even if it may be deadly. Lay down in fields of tall grass and vibrant flowers. Enjoy a couple of midday sun showers. Ride the waves of an ocean or float on the stillness of a lake. Construct a beautiful garden for me. Every day to rake. Oh, for God's sakes, I want to succeed. I want to achieve. I want to believe that I can follow my dreams. I keep racing, I keep chasing. But the fact is that I'm truly erasing. I try and I strive and I seek and I aspire. Except to aspire only gets you to perspire. Stop living in a dream of your life 10 light years away. Start appreciating this incredible day. Worry free, the stress slides off your skin, and all your I want to's start to happen. Slow pace, live at the speed of whatever you feel like. You can stop yourself, you got brakes on your bike. Feeling awake and refreshed, all your sore muscles have been repaired. If you'd like to sit down, go ahead, don't be scared. All of a sudden, you'll start to feel the greatest moments never pass you by when all you wanted to do was watch a sunset in the sky.
So the scores are 9.5,
9.5,
9.5, 10, 9.5, and 10.
The truth. I'm sick of your disheveled appearance and weary eyes, but more importantly, I'm sick of my lies. But I made my bed and I was forced to lie in it. Just like every argument, I wanted to win it. I understand I was out of control, and the situation really took its toll on me and you and your outlook on me too. And even though you already had a problem child, I soon took on that role. Doing what I wanted without repercussions, leaving no time for mother-daughter discussions. I know we drifted apart and I couldn't stand you, but that's something every teenager has to go through. I know all you wanted to do was be a helpful guide, but that's not what I wanted. I wanted to slide. To coast along the ice of my stupidity, I was fine with my version of reality, but good things don't last forever, something I'm all too familiar with. My immaturity was close to a four-year-old, playing with life like building blocks, but were soon knocked down with your wrecking ball of disappointment. I'm sorry for that day when it went downhill, when my innocent image burst into flames. It's not your fault I was impossible to tame. And I don't blame you for locking me up like your precious princess in a castle, because that's all you could do to avoid another disaster. Those all-white walls were suffocating, just like your lack of trust. But even though I didn't understand it at the time, you were just trying to prevent that ticking time bomb of mine. At almost a year later, I finally get it. But surprisingly, I don't regret it. I've never been that disappointed, though it's true the only way to go is up. I learned my lesson from that strict teacher, and now I'm not that self-destructing creature. I show responsibility and effort, something you thought you'd never see. So in the end, Mom and Dad, I sincerely thank you for loving me.
The scores are 9, 9, 7, 10.